When I was an undergraduate at the University of Florida, I was both an astrophysics major and a Vote Everywhere ambassador. Turns out, STEM majors with enthusiasm for voting are not exactly the easiest to find on college campuses. The National Study of Learning, Voting, and Engagement has made this clear. Students in science, technology, engineering, and math are the least likely to vote among their collegiate peers. The silver lining is that this makes a narrow, targetable group in which massive voter turnout growth could be seen with the right intervention. After graduation, I continued my work with the Andrew Goodman Foundation by becoming a Puffin Democracy Fellow, a role in which I applied my research background to dig deeper into this problem. We all know that there are extra burdens to turning out college students in general, but why do STEM students lag so far behind? I surveyed hundreds of students to see what they thought. Non-STEM students theorized that STEM students may be restricted by busy schedules, may lack the civics education to know of voting's importance, or may consider themselves above the electoral process. Well, which is it? Are they aware but uncaring, just uninformed, too strapped for time? It turns out that asking STEM students themselves can be pretty enlightening, as these quotes show. STEM students self-report that the answer is time, but not in the sense that they don't have the time to physically cast the vote. Responses showed that STEM students care deeply about making an educated and informed decision, and several respondents declared they would feel irresponsible taking an uncertain vote. Many students reported taking hours over multiple nights to research the ballot. STEM respondents claimed an overwhelming interest in voting, but felt their schedules made it difficult to participate properly. But the non-STEM students were still onto something. A lack of research time may have been the direct ballot barrier for potential STEM voters, but part of why they feel they need so much research time is because their classes offer little crossover with current events and civic engagement. A plurality of STEM students reported that the election was not brought up in the classroom at all. But 87% of STEM respondents said they want policies which affect their field to be discussed in their courses. So this does point to a gap in STEM education regarding institutional willingness to address policy. So where do we come in? How can we help STEM students bridge this gap? Register. Set up voter registration tabling outside of the computer science building. Host registration competitions between the different engineering colleges. Table at undergraduate research symposiums. Send registration-related links to STEM clubs, asking them to forward the info to their listservs. Educate. Co-host programming that shows the unique relationship between a particular STEM field and policy or civics. This one is trickier than it seems. Remember, STEM students are strapped for time. You may overwork yourself putting together a live stream policy discussion featuring geology faculty, only for very few students to tune in. What are the hot topics in the field? Can professors offer extra credit for student participation? Would shorter video clips on YouTube be more accessible than an hour-long panel? You may not have to reinvent the wheel. Look for existing online resources like podcasts and find new ways to funnel these resources to the students. Engage. Prepare flyers with a list of clubs or local orgs to join based on a cause. When tabling, ask students about their interests. An engineer might hint that they like the potential that new machinery has for medical developments, so maybe hand them a flyer for the Robotic Prosthetics Club. Direct computer science students to mentoring opportunities with Girls Who Code and hackathons. This will help students find a community that goes beyond their coursework, which is a necessary step in discovering one's civic identity. Turnout. This might be easy if the previous steps were thoroughly followed for each and every STEM student, but just in case, let's be creatively prepared. Events like the University of Florida's Battle of the Ballots bring lighthearted competitive fun into the mix by asking students to not only vote for themselves, but for the colleges which host their majors. Within all of these steps should be the reminder that STEM students are not a monolith. International and undocumented students are common STEM groups whose political concerns may not exactly be centered on their science. A professor who speaks eloquently on environmental science policy, yet misgenders students, is a dangerous voice to feature. But you won't have to guess at a student's interests if you just ask them. You won't have to hunt for event speakers if you're in close contact with existing STEM orgs. So, in every step, let us do the most to put these students first by reaching out to offer genuine support and long-term interest in collaboration. Check out stemocracy.org for more information, and please feel free to reach out and schedule a team meeting with me if you'd like to chat more about ideas or involve your school in my research. Thank you, and stay safe.